Hello everyone, my name is the LEGO Kid 2003, and today we're playing some more Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. I'm now slightly paranoid that in the last episode I said Breath of the Wild instead of Tears of the Kingdom. Uh-oh. Oh well, the past few weeks have been really weird. That's literally my only excuse. But yeah, in the last episode, we climbed a huge mountain. We ascended a giant mountain. Boarded at Noah's Ark. And we undid a couple of the locks. There's one lock left. And I think I know how to get it. Especially since I looked up a guide and remembered that I have an ability that literally manipulates time. So, yeah. There's that. Oh yeah, and also I'm about to die. Which is about par for the course, really. I just need to take care of one thing in Pokemon Go, and then we can begin episode. Okay, there we go. Okay. Alright, before we do that, what I need to do is use up, the portable pot to cook some stuff. Why? Because I need food desperately. Go. Of course, I do have to use everything nice and spare. Yeah, I have to be a little bit careful because these pots are one use only. So, yeah. Let's see, what can I? Really increases movement speed, probably not gonna help much. No, stop that. Stay cool in arid regions, probably not great. You know what, for the heck of it, let's do it. Mainly so I can have food. I know that heat resistance doesn't do anything right now, but hey, something's better than nothing. But considering the trends in the last game, I'm anticipating a fight once we take care of the last seal here. So, yeah, I've cooked three things. So, let's take some time, cook some stuff, and go from there. I'm very tempted to just cook a couple of pine cones just to see what happens. I am very curious to see if this even does anything. Eh. Some people would say that was a waste of a cooking pot. I say it wasn't, because I found out what happens if you try to cook pine cones. You get rocks. Okay, what happens if I can't? Okay, so it's only stuff that I can actually eat. Like fire fruit. For some reason. Let's cook these. So yeah, basically, as long as you can eat it, you can cook it and get a somewhat edible result. Oh boy! Okay, so that I am assuming should be fine. But yeah, we only have one left, which is up here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna head to the entrance, and then we're gonna try to do a thing. Who's texting me? Absolutely no one. That's just a notification from a Discord server. Da-da-da-da. Oh, it's that. Anyways. Hi, Tulin. Okay, so let's head over here. And try and see if I can find a way inside. Hey. Yeah, there we go. No. Thank you, Tulin. You're the greatest. Okay, so... Come on. Almost there. Yeah. Oh! Okay. Fun. I basically have to perfectly aim this. Okay, I think I got it. Okay, there. Okay, Tulin, gonna need your special power. There we go. Alright, that's the last lock. Should be able to open up the hatch on the main deck now. Come on, let's go. Assuming that those lasers are still there. Fun. Great. Wonderful. I care not. Map. I can just teleport. Wait. Alright, let's find out what kind of wind blight dragon thing we have to deal with. And hopefully successfully destroy on the first try. What I will do is save right here. So that if I bite it, I'm not losing anything of value. I keep my food. I keep my gems. Then we're fine. What I'll probably do is go no commentary for the boss fight, because Zelda has a really fun habit of just having really awesome music during the boss fights.
Let's go! is that?
Volguera. Alright, that answers my question. That thing's horrifying.
To find a way to hurt it.
for such a horrifying boss that was horrifyingly easy. First up, I will say that I had a feeling that those weird ice platforms would come in handy. Knowing that they could be broken so easily. But either way, Blizzard is now over and done with, and we get another heart out of the whole deal. Just like in the last game with the Divine Beasts. Now, what, my good friend, is that? What? What are you? That is interesting. Anyways, we and now six hearts. Now let's talk to Tulin.
Tulin, my brave fledgling.
I know that voice. It's you. You're the one who's been guiding us?
Yes. I am your ancestor from a time long ago. I proudly served Hyrule's first king. I was a Rito warrior and a sage with control of the wind. Where you fight, the winds follow. I would expect nothing less from my descendant. You make me proud. That monster you defeated, the source of that intense blizzard, it was summoned by the Demon King. He thought it could stop you from obtaining the stone you just found, my secret stone.
Demon King? Secret stone?
This is a lot to learn all of a sudden, I know. But listen while I tell you what happened in the past. A tale of the imprisoning war. And the mission our people must accomplish. Years ago, when the kingdom of Hyrule was still young, a great evil, the Demon King, descended on the land. He sought to wipe out anyone who opposed him. But Rauru, the first king of Hyrule, requested my aid, as well as that of five other warriors, to help in the fight. Rauru entrusted us with amazing artifacts, secret stones, objects that amplified our formidable abilities. I carried one into battle as the Sage of Wind. It was thrilling to fight alongside my fellow sages. Yet we were still no match for the Demon King's overwhelming power. His magic was staggering, and I was unable to slip past his defenses, no matter how hard I tried. In the end, King Rauru realized that we would not be able to defeat the Demon King. To save our world, King Rauru sacrificed himself and sealed the Demon King away.
So that was the imprisoning war.
The rest of us survived that climactic battle. And I would soon receive a visitor with a request that would define the future of the Rito. It was another of the six sages, the Sage of Time.
Is that Zelda?
The Demon King will return. The magic binding him will be undone. When that time comes, a noble swordsman named Link will oppose him. But Link will only succeed with the Rito's help. Summon the winds and support this hero.
It was clear what part Boruto would play.
It will be an honor to defeat the Demon King. I swear to you that when the Demon King returns, Boruto Sage of Wind will awaken once more. And you can count on the full support of Boruto.
And now you know about the imprisoning war, and a mission I accepted on our behalf. You've saved Rito Village, but there's more to do. The Demon King will soon recover his full strength. Tulin, my brave fledgling, you must take up my secret stone and honor the Sage of Time's request. Fight the Demon King with the Swordsman Link.
It's my mission to fight the Demon King with you? Link! This is so amazing! I can't believe my ancestor gave me such an important mission, and it involves fighting alongside you to save the world! If we don't do anything, then the world is gonna be in big trouble. I can't let that happen. I'll do this! I'll happily take this secret stone! Your hand. I, Tulin, the Sage of Wind, swear to fight by your side until the end. Take this. It's proof that I'm with you. You can use that ring to call on my power anytime, all right? Okay, let's head back to the village and tell Dad.
All right, so now we can use Tulin's power whenever we want. Very, very nice. Now, from here, where should we go? Should we visit the Gerudo? Or should we visit the Zora? I definitely will save the Gorons for last. Because I know for a fact, I'm quite sure you're going to need Flamebreaker armor for that area, and I definitely need to save up the rupees needed. For the other areas, armor isn't as needed. So I can kind of hold off on purchasing random stuff until Pardon. Until I'm able to save up enough rupees for the specific armor pieces I need. I guess he did it! Oh, great, it's this guy and his awful haircut. Yeah, turns out it was easy once we started working together. This was no small feat. I still can't believe the Stormwind arc from the children's song was real. Me neither. You could've knocked me over with a feather. For a job well done, Tulin. Wait, what? This bow meant so much to you, and now you're giving it to me? It was always my intention to give it to you once you came of age as a warrior. Dad. Thank you. I'll prove to you I've become a warrior worthy of carrying it. Hey, Link, that woman in the vision my ancestor showed us, didn't she look just like Princess Zelda to you? Do you think that was the real princess? I mean, it seemed like a long, long time ago. There's still a bunch of unanswered questions. I gotta know more about the figure we saw in the Stormwind arc, so I'm gonna go look into it personally. Next time you see me, I'll have more information about Princess Zelda, so check in with me sometime, okay? And remember, with my sage's power, the two of us can keep working together no matter what. Vow of Tulin, Sage of Wind. Proof of the Vow of Tulin, Sage of Wind. Use it to summon or dismiss the Avatar of Tulin. Okay, so we don't always have to have Tulin right beside us. Then again, I'm pretty sure I will have him constantly with me. Okay, so I can bring him up and out with from the Kiatos menu. Gotcha. I need to check a shop. Ship, ship, shop. Here comes the inspector. I'm just a swordsman. I am no inspector. Okay, so. Hey, buddy. Oh, sorry. Okay, now I've fully realized that the Rito Village theme is like a calmer version of the Golgera boss theme. I know it definitely should not have taken me this long to figure it out, but when I was fighting Golgera, that is when I actually noticed, hold up, this sounds familiar. He's going around the village advertising with the Blizzard gone. I can stay stocked up on products with a bit more work. Shop will be better than ever. Nice, nice. I'm here to sell some stuff. I have things to sell. That is what I have for you. Mainly this singular ruby. No, I'm not even kidding. I will definitely have to sell a lot of stuff, because stuff here can get expensive. So I definitely need to save up as much as possible. But, should we go with Zora? Or with the Gerudo? What do you guys think? I'll let y'all think on it. You gonna help me out? But I will say that I will swing back to here for a little bit. So so I can get some more Zonai devices. I'll probably bounce into the caves to try and get more more gemstones so I can sell them. Because, yeah, the more Zonai devices we have at our disposal... I was going to auto-summon Tulin's Avatar. Tulin's Avatar is granted you the power to summon a set. Yep. So, yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to... Hello. The gumball machine that's over here. The air fryer a little bit ago. Wait. Alright. Okay, let's see what I can get. This one too. Things. Okay, yeah, that was definitely a good move. I'll try it a couple more times. Burritos?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay, I think that should be fine. Let's try to find a cape too. Island. There's very little left. Unlikely you'll find enough to produce an energy well. Wonderful. Energy well increases the passive. Okay, so the more energy balls we get, the longer we can use Zonai devices. Yeah, producing, I guess. Are. construct. Crystal refinery. I don't remember where anything is. Yeah, I'm sure with enough exploration I'll be able to re-find everything out. A Korok. Alright. No, I'm not. Has to, but I can indeed see you. Oh, nice. Alright, sounds good. What was I doing? Oh, right, looking for cave systems. Zone I hear. Quite sure. Or not. Oh, wait. Oh, I lied. Here we go. Rusty Halpert, I guess. Yeah, now I have a little zonite. Thank you. charge from here. He's just powered down because he can't find it for Zonite. Okay. Let's put up all of this. There we go. Is that what they want to hear? No. Let's win this a little bit and then trade it for crystallized charges because we will need those later. There, I just have to do that 10 more times and I can get one energy well. These little markers right here tell you where the cave entrances are. Okay. That is very useful information. The cave entrance? Okay. just gonna fly off into the sunset. Alright, so it's over here-ish. Alright, good. Down. And I landed too far again. my. Okay, that's fine. Perfectly fine. I meant to do that. Side cave. Let's just explore. Absolutely not. Okay, that's what I was looking for. I was looking for all those gold old boys. Key symbols are very valuable in this game. That's fine. Charges. Okay, that's fine. Any other caves? I could visit. No, that's fine. And let's go over here. Let's go to Jazora's domain. And help those guys out. Saw that. Eye on the Way. Cool. Let's go there. Congratulations, I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, including one long boy. I wish I had a vehicle, if I'm to be fully honest, to make this a little easier. Ah, boy. I'm gonna switch to the bicycle club. Nope, peppers. I need the peppers. And yeah, Blood Moon's here. Yeah. Let's definitely avoid those guys. Yes, I'm quite sure we've all seen this scene before. The world is certain once again, you're probably not the real Zelda. Placing my bets now. Alright, please, no monster trees if you please. I would rather not. Thank you, what? Okay, totally nothing. Wonderful. So there's a glowing yellow thing right here. I'm loosely curious what that is. Kind wanna figure that out. If it's one of those shooting star things, then I would love to get to it before it disappears. Ooh, I'm tempted, but that's probably not gonna be a good idea. I'm just gonna go the old-fashioned way for now. We're almost there. It's like right up there. Oh, it's a star fragment. Yes. Okay, so that's what that was. Okay, so I'm saving immediately because these things are rare. With a capital R. Oh yeah, there's a shrine over there. Nice. Okay, so I think... yeah, let's go over here. Another shrine over there, and then... or tower. Apologies. Oh, I see a shrine. And spice peppers. Ding, ding, ding. Yeah, there's shrines everywhere. I want to go to this one over here because it's on the way to the tower. You guys leave me alone. I pose no threat. I pose no threat to you. You should pose no threat to me. To only take care of them. Or not. That works too. That's fine. They only get in my way. it's a little fox. Nice. Alright, so let's see if I can... Keep going, keep going. A little more. Yes. Okay, perfecto. Ow, it's one of those... Yep, it's one of those horrifying monstrosities. I'm just gonna ignore you. Because that worked well last time. Mainly because Tillman sniped you. You were going to attack me, and Tulin said, bet. I'm honestly a little paranoid because back in Breath of the Wild, I would have been attacked by, like, a guardian or something at this point, or just something ridiculous. What? Oh. Okay. Huh. Also, not to mention that I haven't really seen anything Gloom-related. Like, if Gloom is anything similar to Malice, then... understandably, I would have found something by now, right? Why is that volcano glowing red? That is concerning. There's a wizard. No, thank you. I'm good. I'm perfectly okay. I'd rather not get struck down with the might of Thor. Okay, so here is... yeah, the next tower's, like, right there. I can do this. And also there's that, giant... gaping hole near a lookout landing that I haven't explored just yet. I probably should check it out. Is that a booby? Yay, I hit it. Uh-huh, 1, 2, 3. Nice. Okay. Why is there a people? Yes, my apologies, it looks like I have a small problem. What's up? This terminal needs repair, so I came to fix it, but... the door won't open, I have no idea why. The door isn't locked, but it won't budge, no matter how hard I push or pull. Of course I know it's a sliding door. Nearby caves. Oh, dang. He is right. Huh. Interesting. Okay, so you mentioned that there are mushrooms in the cave near here. So I guess go into that cave? Going through cave? Oh, jeez. No, stay away. Splash for it. Those probably will be useful later. Bright cap. Uh-oh. Okay, cool. I have another stick. Fuse with the rock. Dwayne Johnson. his life. No, that's not what I wanted you to do. Okay, do I have bomb arrows? Or the bomb flowers? No, I don't. Wait, I can attach a time bomb? Yo. Uh-oh. Okay, so that ended up not what I had in mind. Fire in the hole. Oh, right, I don't have a weapon. Long boy. I had to sacrifice long boy, but it's fine. Spear? Ooh, I get to take your stuff now. All your stuff has belonged to us. Where's the other one? I get wrecked. And that is why Tulin is awesome. And I just wasted his ability. Yay. Let's definitely explore this. Ooh, there's a chest. Got a bunch of stuff. Let's open the chest. Shield of the Mind's Eye. Noise. Bunch of bright blooms. And a giant bright bloom seed. There we go. I don't even know what I just grabbed. So let's grab another one of these bombs. And fire in the hole. All right, because I have to do that again. It's definitely making progress. This ends up using every last one of the time bombs I have. This is gonna get very annoying very quickly. nice. Ooh, an opal. Alright, so that did something. Interesting. Okay, so let's go over here. Okay. Let's see if there's a better place to put this. It's not going to cause it to... everything causes it to roll down. Fine. Okay, let's just see, then. Let's see if the blast is big enough. Nope. Okay, and I don't have any bomb flowers. Is there a big thick weapon I can use? There's a long stick. I can't use that. That's fine. I'm imbecilic. Gone are the mentions of anything normal. Some amber, nice. Perfectly okay. So I can just do it all over again. Hand? I can. What's down here? I want to know. Oh! Gonna take a little more than that, huh? Okay, interesting. No! Ambers and rubies. For like 2 seconds, I was like, what was that noise? And I was just like, yep, it's a giant frog monster. That if you shoot in the head with an arrow, it rewards you. This game rewards you for violence. Okay, for goodness. There. Okay. Let's find a way back up to the surface. Because there are no waypoints that are near here. Oh, there we go. Picked up an appetite, getting her brain. Nearby caves. Okay, I'm confused. Was that not the caves he was referring to? I'm gonna have to look this up, because friend mentioned caves. I went into a cave, found some mushrooms. And I'm just clueless. Oh, that, I'm an idiot. Okay, so I had the right idea going into the cave. What I didn't do right, oh gosh, there's a geoglyph. I'll check that out later. Let's ignore that. Okay, so what I have to do is putz around in this cave until I'm in a position where I'm right above, right below the, or like in line with the icon for the tower. Then I use ascend, go up, bang. And then I should be inside. Just like that. Open. How'd you get inside? Okay, so apparently that wasn't it. Okay. Oh, there's sticks. I'm very... As you probably noticed, I'm not good at video games. There were sticks inside for some reason. Okay. Mechanisms aren't working quite right. I'll just give them a bit of oil. There we go. Examine. And now time for me to do the funny. You guys know what I'm talking about, do you? Don't you? Do you guys know what I'm referring to when I say that I'm gonna do the funny? Where I'm gonna do the, I'm gonna do the silly thing? The funny ha-has? Skylar's just a space here. If there's even any. Yeah, there's kind of. And boom. Oh, there's another one of those, giant holes. No jokes, chat. Okay, yeah, there are Sky Island things, but not a lot. Okay. Anyways. We... If I end up landing it again... I think I might actually land it again. Okay, that was perfect timing. Okay, so for those who didn't know what I was trying to attempt in the first place, I have this really fun habit of, whenever I unlock a new tower, I allow it to send me straight up, and then I just immediately turn around and just dive straight down. To try and see if I can time it just right to where I can deploy the paraglider before I hit the bottom. And if I fail, I laugh hysterically. At my own stupidity. Is there... Frog. Okay. What might this be? I don't know what this is. What's over here? Hylian tomato. Oh, yeah. A fruit found widely from cold areas to warm climates, full of nutrition, and kind of trendy lately. Use it in cooking to recover more hearts. Wait. Is there a tomato? Wait, are we going to, Kakariko? Kakariko Village? Salad room. I think this is Kakariko. It is, I recognize that symbol. Ancient Chica Wars. Yep, Kakariko Village. Nice. Hello. Okay. Very nice.
Boop.
And general store. General store. Zonai survey team base. And then an armor shop. And there's just a giant gaping hole here. I wanna... Lady Pia? Donde? Is it you? The ring ruins are the most intriguing ruins I've ever researched, especially this one, the way part of it floats up there. You had the foresight to focus on all these special ruins and invite the survey team to take a look right away. I'm impressed, Chief Pia. Oh, you're kind of attractive. No, Chief, I just couldn't refuse my predecessor when she decided to pass the title to me rather suddenly. Oh, that explains the giant hat. Okay. I'm really a chief in name only, since I still have a great deal to... Hmm? Yo. Oh, is that you, Master Link? Please don't call me Master. Chat's gonna get really weird about it. I'm so happy that I get to see you again. I'm... happy to see you, too. I'm overjoyed that both you and Princess Zelda are sitting there. Approximately 50% of that statement is actually accurate. Step on here. But yeah, only 50% of that statement's actually true. What, Princess Zelda still... Yep. That just confuses the matter more. You see, I actually met with the... What? It was immediately after the upheaval. Princess Zelda came here to Kakariko Village. Sus. She ordered us all to stay far away from the ring ruin that floats above us, no matter what. I saw her myself right before my eyes. That is very concerning. Also, I want to explore those ruins. You thought it was to protect the villagers from harm? This ruin does look like it could crash down at any moment. That's a play on, I suspect at least, but still I know you would not misspeak, Master Link, especially on a matter of such importance. How confusing. Oh, my apologies. I was so pleased to see you. I completely forgot common courtesy. Please allow me to introduce Mr. Toro, an esteemed member of the Zonai Survey Team. I invited him here to investigate the ring ruins that fell on our village. He has incredibly deep knowledge of the Zonai civilization. He's even familiar with Zonai script. He's truly an incredibly talented individual. And also, again, quite attractive. It's clear that the floating ring ruin that we were forbidden to explore is a unique and incredibly valuable find. Several more ring ruins with such a shape have fallen down around the village. Most have broken apart in some way. What's fascinating is that a stone slab with writing was found at each site. Deciphering the text showed that each slab contains rather interesting content, including mention of sages. There's still so much we don't understand. I think that perhaps the ruin floating in the air also has a slab that makes mention of the sages. I can't investigate as that would go against Princess Zelda's direct orders. If only I could meet with her again, I'm sure I could persuade her to change her mind. Or you could just send me up there. In any case, I'm having trouble squaring your story about Princess Zelda with the Princess Zelda we met. If everything is alright, why won't she just show herself? She must have some reason. Until we find out Princess Zelda's true intentions, we have no choice but to trust her and leave that ruin alone. Cool story, bro. Hi. Come here. No. Oh, and you heard it's strictly forbidden to... Yeah, it's forbidden to you guys. It's forbidden for y'all. For me, not really. I can do whatever I want. Lady of Rules. Ah, dang it. That was just a plan. I was about to say bully to your rules and just try to go up there anyway, but yeah, the rain's not really letting me. Let me see. Hi. Probably when it stops raining. Oh wait, no, it's not raining anymore. Cool. So that means we can say bully to that guy's rules. I swear, if I can actually sneak past this guy, I'm gonna start laughing. Yep. Wow. Hey, look! I'm near the ruin. Ooh, shrine. Hey, look! I'm near the ruins. You can't stop me. Okay, I'm gonna stop mocking people. I'm gonna stop mocking an ancient race of people. Yeah, it's so funny that it like has jurisdiction over that specific spot. And if you try approaching from any other angle, he's just like, oh, look at that, you're going towards the ring ruins, just like I told you not, just precisely as I said not to. Oh well, good luck. I just find that so funny. Wait. That's one of those gumball machines. It's a gumball machine. It's a Zonai gumball machine. I want the gumballs. Let's see what I get from here. New stuff. Stabilizer, a perfectly balanced Zonai device that stands upright when activated. It was used to secure footholds in unstable places such as sky. Ooh, very useful. Balloon. Fan, stabilizers. Okay, so it looks like it's mainly stabilizers, fans, and balloons. Right? Balloon, fan, something, and then stabilizer. Okay, so there's one more device from in here that I haven't actually found. Alright, let's see if I can get it. Let's see if I can get the new thing. Looks like I can. Big wheel. A powered Zonai device that wants to move. It's a big, mean wheel that excels at tearing through environments that might challenge smaller wheels. It can handle shallow water. Interesting. Okay, let's just burn up, let's do one more round. Yeah, it's cool that, these guys have a Zonai gumball machine. I guess you really can find them on ground level. Nice. Anyways, what was I doing? Oh, right. I remember now. I recall what I was doing now. I was gonna activate this shrine. Well, alright, I might as well complete it. Makasura. Or Makasura. Anyways, let's see what's in here. That giant gaping hole concerns me. Oh, that's what those tree things are called. Ever means. Oh. I see what they did. I see what they did there. Anything I can mess with? No. Can I just... Woo-woo? Yes. Wait. Cheesing. Anyways. What are these? What are you? Pick up. Interesting. So what happens if I smack it? Oh, you're a stabilizer. Interesting. Uh-huh. Okay, let's figure this out. I mean, logically speaking, I can probably just... What I can probably do Oh, can I not take out devices here? Oh, boo. Okay, so that means I have to somehow use these stabilizers. And this. To get over there. Okay, interesting. Wait. Out of curiosity, what happens if I do this? Wait. You know what? That works. That works, I think. Come on. Yeah. I don't know why that worked, but that somehow did. Okay, so by our logic, we can basically just do the same thing we did last time. But let's make it fun. Boom. Yay. Anyways. I'm really sorry, I have the song stuck in my head. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is do this, then this. How high can I bring you? Not particularly. Okay. Wait. Oh, I know what I'm supposed to do. I think I get it. I think I know the things. Because this is a stabilizer, so that does that. Yay. Oh, right, I can just go whoop whoop. I can just do the whoop whoops. I can literally just use this then. I have no brain cells. No. There's no way that I actually did that. Huh. Okay then. So how, how am I supposed to use this? Ooh, I think I know now. I think what I'm supposed to do first up, deactivate this. to do. Let's do this. Put that there. Go right here. Remember, I don't have a bow equipped. All right, let's see if this works. Yep. That works. A little too well. I almost got launched straight through the ceiling. But it matters not. Try and complete. Visitor the shining light, blah 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 blah. Light of buzzing. Alright, one more and I can. You know, I'm gonna start working on stamina. Cause it's a little too early to be worrying about the Master Sword. Okay, so now that I have that taken care of, let's actually go back to what I was doing. Let's also make sure I'm heading in the right direction. I am not. I need to be going that-a-way. Not that-a-way towards scary burning volcano. Okay. I can't use tool. Right, I can't use Tulin's power whenever I'm in a place like a village. Right. Because plot reasons, I guess. I don't really know why. I can't, why I can't use Tulin. Oh well. I'm sure it's fine. Okay, there we go. Now I'm outside of the bounds of Kakariko. Wait. Let's head up here real fast. See if my hunch is correct. East Hill. So I'm guessing this is the same thing as what I saw in Lookout Landing, right? Yeah. Whoa. Whoa. That is huge. That is gigantic. That is very sizable. Okay, I am giving that place a wide berth. Hi, horrifying bat creature. That will stay away from me. Okay, so I'm not entirely sure when I'll start exploring those, when I'll start, looking through those and seeing what those are all about. But I'm sure I'll investigate them at some point. There's just a shadow cube over that tower. That's interesting. But But yeah, in terms of like anything Glimmer related, those giant holes are the only things I've seen. I'm slightly hoping I can find something a little more than that. Nope. Stay away from me. Stay away from me, SpongeBob slime. Don't ask me why I called the Electro Choo Choo that. Because I will be unable to provide you with an answer. That's just SpongeBob was literally the first thing that came to my head when I just saw yellow and I immediately thought SpongeBob. I have information. They're great. What does this even do? Oh, nothing cool. It just spins you around. Oh, I don't want to stop wasting time. I'm going to stop wasting precious time, and I'm going to continue going towards village. Ooh. What was that? Gordon? Was that this? Recall. Alright, the way I said recall sounds like I just said Rico. Looks a little murkier than I remember. I don't like it. It's kind of gross. Oh no. No. Somehow I did that. Also, there's a tower right there. Ew. Oh, fun is one of those weird slug monsters. Let's try and make my way up there. Nope, you leave me alone. You don't see me. Everything's fine. I think we should be able to make it. At least part of the way. Yay. Grief. Okay, there. Oh, it's Lizalfos. Nope, not happening. Goodbye. fleet lotus seeds. Can I swim in this water? Yes, I can. Interesting. Ugh. Okay, now I can just smell what the water might smell like, and I'm just not liking it. Okay. Anyways, continue climb to the tower. I'll probably go, like, a little bit into... Alright, no, it's technically not overtime until I hit 2.5 hours. So, we're still good. We haven't hit overtime yet. Okay, it's right there. Right there. I literally just gotta go. Stop moving around so much. Oh, Bloopy. You absolute jerk. Dang it. Well, there goes my prospect of any meat. Okay, after we figure out the stuff about the tower, then we'll... Oh boy, hello. No, you leave me be. Blech. Haha. Get wrecked by my sheer determination. Oh, you absolute jerk. Get over here. I don't even know where they are. Oh, there you are. That's your own fault. Get wrecked. No. For 2 seconds, I thought that was one of the monsters. How's there another one of you? I destroyed you. I killed you. I shot you out of this- there. Good grief. Away with you. Upland Zorana. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we got splash fruit earlier. What happens if I just... Oh. That was unusually easy. Oh, I forgot to save. Ah, shoot. Oh, there's Sky Islands. There's stuff here. Alright, that means that means it's probably dangerous to do the funny ha-has, though. Oh, everything's green. That's gross. Alright, there's kind of Sky Islands. I'm just experiencing a Sky Island drought right now. A little too early, but I'd rather it be too early than too late. Because if it's too late, then I die. Okay, there we go. Got another tower. Sticky frog. Nice. Pine cone and splash fruit. Goodbye. Am I even going in the right direction? No? Okay, yeah. What I'm supposed to be doing is over this way. Ugh. So gross. Just like always, there's a shrine right there. Whoa, whoa. What is this? Is this a, is the sky just pooping? Everyone has been treated, but we have used up all the splash fruit. Orange is anticipated, except my apology. Okay, this is just a side quest. Sludge, that's what it is. Yeah, that's a Mepha statue, right? Wait. Well, that's Sidon. And me? Oh. That statue depicts the majestic forms of the pair who saved this cherished domain in the past. So, yeah, Sidon and the player. I find it so funny that they don't recognize me immediately. It's simply wonderful, is it not? How I would love to meet him someday. Yep. Hi. Hello. We're fine, we're good. Everyone who's watching Reefer's stream, because Twitch decided to be mean. Twitch decided to do a mean. I need to transfer this over, don't I? Export. Public. begin. And let's make sure everything's transferring over correctly. So I don't lose valuable footage. Okay, cool. So I can refresh this, make sure that the stream didn't split, because I hate it when that happens, because I have to edit everything later. Okay, cool. But yeah, good for sliding. Nice to meet you. I'm truly honored to have the opportunity to meet you, Sir Link. Yona, caretaker to the Zora. Wait, so were we supposed to do this? I heard you're missing along with Princess Zelda, if I may ask what brings you here. Pura said a bunch of weird stuff was happening, so I'm here to investigate, like a detective. To think that such a thing took place beneath Hyrule Castle and now you're traveling the Kingdom of Vet. Yep. So your search for Zelda is what brought you to this domain. Yep. In that case, feel free to investigate the area around the domain as thoroughly as you see fit. Oh, I have a lovely idea. If you do not mind, ask that you please go and meet with Sidon. I am certain that he would be delighted to see you. Sidon can be found at Mipha Court, located at the peak of Paloimus Mountain. Up there, huh? If you must be going now. Forgive me, Sir Link, but I must be on my way. Alright, bye-bye. But if it pleases you, after you've met with Sidon, perhaps you could visit me at the infirmary on the floor above. I'm determined to be of assistance to you as best I can, Sir Link. Thanks? Oh, that was a main quest, okay. Sidon of the Zora, so... considering what happened in Rito Village, I'm guessing Sidon is going to be the next sage. So, if Sidon was the Sage of Winds, and Zora's domain is all about, like, oceans and seas and cool stuff like that, my best guess is that Sidon is going to become the Sage of Water. Basically following an almost Avatar-like path. And when I say Avatar, I mean the good Avatar, not the blue people. I'm not referring to the blue people, I'm referring to the only form of media that can actually claim the name of Avatar and not have people cringe. I'm, of course, talking about Avatar The Last Airbender. My goodness, try saying that 5 times fast. I bet you can't. You cannot say Avatar The Last Airbender 5 times fast. But yeah, let's go say hi to Sidon. And then after that, we will end stream. I will not hold you guys here for all that much longer, hopefully. Okay, there's literally no faster way up there. I have to do this the long way. Okay. Let's hope we can, get up there. Because that would be great. How fun is more of those horrifying demon bats? Oh, wait, no, never mind. It's just geese. We're fine. I think what I can do is I can pop over here, this little ledge, get a stamina back. Hi, Tulin. And then immediately start heading up. Oh, there's one of those rocks. I'm making my way downtown, walking fast. Face is past, but I'm homebound. I am combat, I am nobility. I don't know how to play video games. I kind of know what I'm doing. Okay, I was about to say, ooh, it's down here, but yeah, it's nothing really. All that worth my attention. Definitely seems like part of the place is broken down a little bit. That just me. Oh, it's a wizard. No, you leave me be. Shoot. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. I got spotted. I got this. It's not good. Leave me alone. I don't wish you harm. Please don't tell me it's not going to do the thing where it's going to storm. I don't like it when that happens. Okay, East Reservoir. I'm sorry, but I can't view this stuff as sludge when I just see it falling down from the sky. Like, is it just me? But I just can't. Allow. Fine. I guess if you want to be boring. Nope, you don't see me. You don't see me, you're lying. Okay, there. That worked. Okay, cool.
All right, I'll go to bed, babe. I gotta get up early. Sweet dreams, babe.
Same to you.
Love you.
Love you too. Do you have a tournament tomorrow morning?
Well, it's Tri-Cups, which I know doesn't mean anything.
Okay, so yeah, there's the wizard again. Okay, yeah, I have to climb. Simply going whoop whoop is not an option now. Oh, that's a way on a stamina to get up there. This is a climb. Come on, almost there. Almost there. Oh, I'm not gonna make it. Oh no. Ow. Okay, let's see if there's an easier way to do this. Again, I stop living, which is not ideal. That is simply the cruel fate that I live in. giant holes over there. I don't have enough stamina. Alright, let's pop over here. Let's see if I can find a solution on this side. Can I do the poops? No, I can't. Doesn't seem like there's a... Oh, I know there might be. I found my way up. We're doing it. Uh-oh. No. You jerk. I was nearly there. You guys saw that. I was basically there. And careful. Ugh. Dang it. I don't know how to... So I can't ascend through there and just make my way up that way. Can't go over there, because that's where the wizard is. Actually, you know what? No, I'm gonna go where the wizard is. That's the only thing I haven't officially tried. I know it sounds exceedingly foolish, but what other plans do I have? I wanna at least get up there. Yeah, I can get a send here. Come on. Give me a good spot. There. Okay, so now I should be able to avoid the wizard. I think this should give me a good ledge to... Okay, yeah. Now we're making progress. We're making it, I think. I'm gonna go over here. So I think I might actually be able to stand. Nope. That's doing so well. Oh, I can. Cool. I wasn't expecting that. How close am I? Slowly getting there. I think. keep spamming ascend, I guess. The water here is a little cleaner. That's good. I'm really taking a long way. Doable. Okay, that was an epic fail. Of the highest degrees. Okay, it's fine. I'll find another way up. As a child, oh boy. They were good at two. Nice. Okay. Get my arrow. Okay. I think we made it. I told you guys we would make it. think now's a good time to end the episode. And Mipha Gordon. Anyways. If you guys enjoyed this stream and you're on the YouTube side of things, then please be sure to comment, like, subscribe, and as always, stay awesome. And if you're one of the lovely people who decided to take time out of your day, afternoon, or evening to come watch this stream live, as it is happening, or if you're for the 2 weeks that it's on Twitch before I transfer it over, then please be sure to drop a follow, maybe even a subscription if you have not done so already, and as always, long live the Rebellion.